Hello everyone and welcome back to our home studio. I hope you all are doing well. In today's video, we are going to discuss and compare the fueling systems available in the market, and they are carburetors and fuel injections. Alongside that, we are going to tell you why FIs are better than the carburetors. But before we proceed ahead, you know the drill. Subscribe to the channel and ring that bell so you never miss an update from Rev Explorers. You can also get in touch with us on our social media platforms, that is Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. The links will be down here. And if you have done this kind of a hairstyle, which is called as a quarantine hairstyle, then you are awesome. Anyways, without deviating more from the topic, let's quickly jump into carburetors and fuel injections. Nowadays, with the BS6 kicking in, we see many of the two-wheeler manufacturers ditching the carburetor systems and switching to FI technology. Also in cars, I remember Maruti 800 was the last car that I remember had a carburetor system, and after that all the vehicles moved to fuel injection. So why these manufacturers are going into fuel injection, why are not sticking to carburetor? To understand it all, we'll start with the carburetors first. The carburetor might look complicated, but it is actually a very simple device. It is a completely mechanical device with no electronics attached to it. In simple words, when the piston inside the engine moves downwards, due to the vacuum created, the air and fuel mixture is sucked into the combustion chamber. The carburetors get the air directly from the air filter and the fuel from the tank. Now, to further increase the air velocity entering inside the combustion chamber, carburetor has a restricted air passage, which is also known as venturi. Now, by increasing the velocity of the air through the narrow area, a low pressure pocket is created, which draws the fuel from the jets placed near the venturi. Now, the fuel jets directly draw the fuel from the tank via float chamber, which is a small reservoir for fuel with a float valve on it. This valve cuts off the fuel intake the moment the chamber is full. And again, when the carburetor draws fuel from the float chamber, it again takes some fuel into the reservoir from the tank. So this goes on and on and on till the time your engine is running. Now, the amount of air fuel mixture entering the engine is decided by a valve, also known as the throttle valve, which is directly connected to your accelerator grip. So when you pull the throttle valve opens and allows the air fuel mixture to get into the combustion chamber, which makes your engine run. This is a very basic explanation of how a carburetor works. The modern day carburetors, including your constant velocity carburetors, are more complex in design, and they use components like your diaphragm, needle valve, and pilot jets to control the airflow mixture. And do remember that this device is completely mechanical with no electronics or sensors. Let's quickly discuss the advantages of a carburetor. Obviously, the cost is less, they are simple in operation, easy to repair and replace. Users can tune their carburetors according to their requirements, and they can be easily serviced or replaced without touching any part of the engine. And there are some disadvantages as well, like they are not the most efficient system. Most carburetors have a slight lag, which results in slow throttle response. Certain components like diaphragm are relatively delicate and prone to damage. The air fuel mixture might fluctuate, affecting the engine smoothness, and also they get affected by surroundings like pressure, air temperature, and elevation. On the other hand, the electronic fuel injection system comprises of complex set of electronics and sensors. They might look simple, but the functioning is very complex. Unlike the carburetor systems, the fuel injection systems use a fuel pump which is mounted inside the fuel tank for a better control over the flow of fuel. And the fuel injection nozzle directly goes inside the combustion chamber. The pressurized fuel is very well atomized by the FI system, which gives you a efficient and clean combustion. This supply is controlled by an ECU, or also known as electronic control unit. And I can say that in fact the whole FI system is controlled by the ECU, which is doing very complex calculations at the back end with a very high frequency taking in consideration the engine temperature, engine speed, and your throttle position, and many more factors, so that it can deliver the best air fuel mixture to your engine at that time. So this ECU controls the injectors to let just the right amount get inside the combustion chamber for an efficient combustion. And that is how your fuel injection system works. And the advantages of having an FI system are: the optimized air fuel mixture allows a cleaner and more efficient combustion. The FI system gives you a sharper throttle response and a better fuel efficiency at low emissions. Typically, an FI system is maintenance free and doesn't break down so easily. And also, your fuel injector gives you an optimized performance irrespective of the surroundings. It is not dependent on the surrounding air pressure, air temperature, or in fact elevation. It can give you the best output in any terrain. But there are disadvantages to the fuel injection system. And the first one is that they are more expensive than the carburetors. Secondly, you cannot repair them with simple tools. You have to get them replaced, which is expensive. And last but not the least, they cannot be customized like carburetors. I mean, you can customize it, but then you'll have to change the ECU mapping, which is again costly. Also, it may void your warranty. So I would suggest not to do that until unless you know what you are doing. Now let's quickly compare carburetor with the fuel injection system. So the design of the carburetor is simple, whereas FI is complex. The repairing of the carburetor is simple. In fact, you can also do it if you know what has to be done. Whereas repairing an FI could be a complex task, and in some cases you will have to replace it. The performance in carburetor may vary depending upon the surrounding conditions, whereas in the FI they stay optimized and constant. Considering a same size of engine for carburetor and FI, the emissions in carburetor are slightly higher than the FI, and the efficiency of the carburetor is slightly lower than the FI. And definitely the cost of the carburetor is low, whereas the FIs are expensive. So by now you would have got a clear picture of why the FIs are better than the carburetors. And because of their high efficiency and low emissions from the tailpipe, almost all the manufacturers have shifted to the FI systems. I know this makes your vehicle slightly expensive by 10 to 15,000, but then if you see in a longer run, you are reducing your carbon footprint. Okay, that means you are contributing less to the air pollution. Secondly, you are getting a higher fuel efficiency, which will definitely increase your fuel economy and reduce the running cost of your car or bike. And manufacturers have shifted from carburetors to FI because of the stringent BS6 norm. And now the smallest segment engine is also fitted with a fuel injection. So don't worry, we'll be back with a complete video on BS6 just for you, explaining all the norms and regulations that are going to be enforced in India. So don't forget to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell, so you never miss an update from Rev Explorers. And if you still have any queries or any questions, just put them down in the comment section below, or you can directly ask us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. We would be happy to reply to you. I hope this video was helpful for you. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it with your family and friends. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, stay safe and stay home.